So good morning plus two. Yesterday we have started the Python connectivity with MySQL coding. Okay. So I'm going to explain the code once again from the beginning. So pay attention carefully and wherever you have doubt, you can ask me. Okay. So before we start the connectivity, the most important concept is we need to download the MySQL connector. MySQL connector is useful as it will help the Python interface to get connected with the database application. Okay, got it? So I have import MySQL.connector. Then using the connect function of MySQL connector, you have to connect your Python interface with the database server, right? The connect function is the inbuilt function of this module, MySQL.connector. So using this connect function, what I have done, I have tried to make connection between the Python interface and MySQL database server. So these are the parameters which are used in the connect function. First is host. The value of host is localhost. Then user. The value of the user is root. And I have empty password. So I have passed the empty string. If you have set any password, you can enter that password. Okay. Then the fourth parameter, as I told you yesterday, is the name of the database. If you have already created the database and you want to connect with the existing database, then you pass the database name here. Like I have already created the database term 2. So I want to connect with term 2. So I am passing directly the name of database term 2. But if you want to create database with the command create database, you can do that. Okay, you can do that also. Clear? So this again, I am over entering the class. Okay. Now this CONN1. This is my connection object. This is my connection object. You can give any name you want. I have given the name con1. Using this connection object, I am checking whether I am able to get successfully connected with the server or not. How I can check that? By using this inbuilt function is_connected. This function will help me to check whether I am successfully connected with the server or not. If this function evaluates to true, the message will get print successfully connected with the server. Okay, got it? Then the next important thing which you will be requiring in the project work is cursor object. You are going to create the table under the database. You are going to insert records in the table. You are going to work upon the table. You will put queries on the table. When you put queries on the table, definitely you are going to retrieve some records. Now, when you retrieve the records, you retrieve the record as complete result set. Complete set of records is displayed. From that complete set of record, which is known as result set, you have to pick up the relevant records which satisfies your criteria. You have to pick up the relevant records which satisfies the condition, which satisfies your criteria. For those queries, for all those MySQL queries which you want to put on the table, cursor object will help you. Cursor object is vitally important object that will help you to execute whatever query you want to put on the table. How to create the cursor object? Take the connection object dot cursor function and allot any name to your cursor object. I have taken the name C. So con1 is my connection object. C is my cursor object. Okay. Now, the first query which I am going to create is create database academics. Create database query. And the name of database which I want to give is academics. Right? Put this query enclosed in double quotes. Enclose this query in double quotes and assign this query to any variable. I have given the name C1. You can give any name you want. Then, using the cursor object, use the inbuilt function execute in order to execute your query. Inside this execute function, I am passing my query variable to which I have assigned the query as a parameter. Agar aap ye kaam nahi karna chahte, to aap ek kaam aur kar sakte ho. If you don't want to assign your query to some variable, you can directly write your query here. Okay, got it? It is up to you how you want to run it. If you don't want to assign your query into some different variable and then passing the variable as a parameter in the execute function, you can directly pass your query in the execute function. But it is convenient to assign the query to some variable and then passing the variable in the execute function. In the entire explanation of this short demo project, I will be assigning the query to some variable, then I'll be putting the variable as parameter inside the execute function. Am I clear up till here? Yes, please. 12th class, am I totally clear up till here? All right. Then finally, I print the message database get created successfully. Now pay attention carefully that I have make this command as a comment. Ye chalegi nahi. Maine isko comment bana diya. If you want to disable any command, but you don't want to delete it, aap sirf usko disable karna chahte ho, usko comment bana do. अब मैंने इसको कमेंट क्यों बनाया? मैंने जब ये प्रोग्राम चलाया था ना, तो मेरा डाटाबेस क्रिएट हो चुका था. आई ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड द डाटाबेस. नाउ इफ आई डोंट मेक इट अ कमेंट, इट विल ट्राई टू क्रिएट अगेन द डाटाबेस एकेडमिक्स विच इज ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड. सो पाइथन विल जनरेट एरर हियर. पाइथन विल जनरेट एरर द डाटाबेस विद दिस नेम ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्ट. वाई टू indulge in such error? So I have made this command as a comment. Now it will be ignored. Execution to isi command se hogi na, iska koi effect nahi hai. Iska koi effect nahi hai because execution is command se honi hai. Aur maine execution wali command ko hi comment bana diya. So now it will not create the database with the same name. It will ignore it. Are you getting what I want to say to you guys? Yes. I don't know why you give so slow feedback to me. Okay. Now this I have create one function, create database. Maine alag alag functions banaye hue aur un functions ko baad mein call kiya. So this was my first function, create database function in which I am creating the database. Okay. Then after successfully you create your database, the next function which I have make is create table. पर सबसे पहले मैं आपको इसको रन करके दिखा दूं एक बार. लेट मी ओपन माय एसक्यूएल कनेक्टिविटी आल्सो, माय एसक्यूएल आल्सो. आई हैव टू ओपन द वैम्प सर्वर. सो आई ओपन माय एसक्यूएल हियर. Is MySQL window visible to all? All right. So I'm coming back to my project and temporary time I am running it. See, don't look at other commands. Baki sari commands bhool jaiye. Sirf first line pe dhyan rakho. Successfully connected with the server. Database get created successfully. Just pay attention on these two commands. Just because all my commands are correct, all my modules are working, all my connector, my MySQL connector is working. So I got this message that I am successfully connected with the server. All right. So next function which I have make is how to create table. Now pay attention on this function, create table. ये सारे चीजें भूल जाओ, इस function पे ध्यान रखो जो मैंने shared किया हुआ है. All right, how to create table? The way you create table in MySQL, create table, table name, round bracket, name of the field, name of the data type, comma, name of the field, data type, then any constraint you want. Primary key or unique key or not null or default constraint, whatever you need, put those constraints and finally close the round bracket and put the semicolon and you get your table get created. Got it? Now here in this function, again, I have make the connection with the database, but see this command. See this command. I have already provided the name of database. मैंने database का नाम पहले यहां पर लिख दिया क्योंकि मैं database के साथ connect हो चुका हूं. Right? Now in this function, अभी मैं इस function के अंदर local चल रहा हूं. The cursor object created here has no connection with the cursor object created over here. Okay, got it? So what I have done, I again created the cursor object by using the connection object along with the cursor function. Aur maine apne cursor object ko kya naam diya? C. Right? Now, the way you give the command to create the table, similarly create the command to create the table. The way you give in MySQL exactly same. Create table EMP1. The name of my table is EMP1. Round bracket starts. First field I am taking E code of type integer, comma E name. Of string type, character of 20 size, e salary of float type, comma e department again of string type. This was my last field. Then I close this opening bracket of table over here. I put the semicolon and I enclose the complete command inside the double quotes and I assign the complete SQL query to variable C1. Okay. Just in the above function, I assign the command to variable C1. Here also, I am assigning this complete MySQL command to to a variable C1. It is not hard and fast rule that every time you have to take C1, you can take any name. Q1, T1, whatever name you want. Okay. Then put this variable inside the execute function in order to execute the command so that your table get created. Clear to everyone? Since already my table is created, I have made this command as a comment. Agar main isko abhi comment se hata dunga na, to ye dobara koshish karega usi naam ke table ko create karne ki, aur Python will generate an error because it will say table already exist. Error will come that table already exist. Am I clear? Then finally, I print the message table get created successfully, because without any error, I got successful in creation of my table. So again, I run the program and I show you the next output. See here, table gets created successfully. And I can show the relevant table in MySQL also. Connect academics DESC EMP1. Ye dekho. Whatever queries I am doing in Python, corresponding results are being displayed in MySQL. Now I am not directly working in MySQL. I am working in MySQL via Python. I am giving the MySQL queries, but via Python interface. Okay. Am I clear to all? Yes, please. Plus two. Are you here only? Any doubt, any question to any one child? All right. So moving to the next function, that is to insert the record. Now here you have variation. Yahan par aapke paas variation hai. Whether you want to insert one record, whether you want to insert multiple records, whether you want to insert the record as bypassing the required parameters. Okay. So here in front of you, what I have done, I have left the choice on the user. Maine user pe choice chhod diye. Till the user want, he or she will keep on entering the records in the table. Okay. I'll show all the methods to insert the record. So here I have taken the function insert record. Inside this function, again, I have created the connection object and I have created the cursor object. Okay. I have taken a variable answer whose initial value I have set to Y. I have taken the variable answer whose initial value I have set to Y. Y means yes. Till the answer variable is having the value Y, whether in lowercase or whether in uppercase. Till the answer variable has the value Y, whether in lowercase, whether in uppercase, the loop will continue to run. Agar Y ke ilawa, you will try to type any other key except lowercase y or uppercase y, you try to enter any value while loop will stop. The loop will not continue with the operations. Okay. Now, what are the four fields which I have taken? E code, E name, E salary, E department. So I have inputted them all. Maine user se input karwa liye. E code is of type integer. So I have given the integer function over here and I input the value of E code. E name is of type string. So using the input function, I have inputted the name of the employee. Then salary is of type float. So using the float function, I inputted the value of salary. And last but not the least, E department, again, it is of type string. So I have taken directly input function and I am entering the department from the user side. So all together, my table has four fields: E code, E name, E sal, E department. Okay. And on the basis of their data types, correspondingly, I have inputted them from the keyboard. Now I have made one sequence of it. You can make any sequence. Maine list banayi hai. Aap tuple bana lo. E code, comma, E name, comma, E cell, comma, E department. All the variables I enclosed in the square bracket and I assign the name V. This is my list object. You can make tuple if you want. Maine usko list ki form mein represent kar diya. And what is the name of the list object which I have created? It is V. Okay. Now, as you used to type the query in MySQL, insert into emp1 values. Aap aise values dete the na? 1, comma Amit, comma salary 40,000 and department is sales. Aap log aise query dete the? Okay. Same thing I have done here. Instead of giving the values in the values function, ye jo aapne values pass ki hai na, ye jo values pass ki hai, 1, Amit, 40,000, sales, values ki jagah value nahi pass karni. When you are entering the record via Python, you pass percentage s format string. Percentage s is a format string that will replace the field with the corresponding value. पहला परसेंटेज एस ई कोड को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, सेकंड परसेंटेज एस ई नेम को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, थर्ड परसेंटेज एस ई सैलरी को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, फोर्थ परसेंटेज एस ई डिपार्टमेंट को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है. अकॉर्डिंगली इट विल रिप्लेस योर फील्ड्स विद द वैल्यूज दैट यू विल प्रोवाइड. ओके, गॉट इट? So, ये जो परसेंटेज एस मैंने पास किए, एनीबडी कैन टेल मी ये किसको रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं इस टाइम? इफ यू आर थॉरली लिसनिंग द लेक्चर, यू विल डेफिनेटली गिव द आंसर. अगेन मौलिक. यस मौलिक,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग
सर. दीज रिप्रेजेंट ई कोड, ई नेम,
Yes, ये जो मैंने यहां पर पास किया है. वेरी गुड, वेरी नाइस. नाउ सी व्हाट आई हैव पास्ड इन द एग्जीक्यूट फंक्शन. What I have passed in the execute function, anybody can tell me? ध्यान से execute function देखो जो मैंने shared किया हुआ है. What I have passed here? Yes, please use your common sense, use your intelligence level and tell me what I have passed inside the execute function. Yes, Sanvinder, unmute yourself.
That's our C1 in which we have entered that input, the values E code, E name, E cell, and E depth will be executed in the list. We will be executed.
Okay. C1 to ho gayi meri query. C1 to ho gayi meri query. Don't unmute yourself right now. Abhi aap okay. C1 to ho gayi meri query. अब ये जो फॉर्मेट स्ट्रिंग है परसेंटेजेस, इट हैज टू बी रिप्लेस विद द वैल्यूज. वैल्यूज आई हैव गिवन हियर इन द वी वेरिएबल एज अ लिस्ट, सो दैट वैल्यूज आल्सो आई हैव पास्ड एज द पैरामीटर. यू आर राइट एट योर पॉइंट सनविंदर, बट आई हैव मेक इट मोर इलेबोरेट. आई हैव मोर इलेबोरेटेड. ओके, गुड रिस्पॉन्स. नाउ वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, whenever in the project you will run insert command, you have to save that command in the database. In order to save that command, the inbuilt function is commit, and commit function is always used along with the connection object, not with the cursor object. MySQL ke link jitni bhi commands execute karni hai using execute function, it is always associated with the cursor object. But while committing, when you want to save it, you have to use the connection object. Okay, got it? Insert or update ke time, when you are inserting record, when you are updating the record, commit function is compulsory to be used. Now come here. C dot row count. Row count is inbuilt variable. It is used along with the cursor object. This variable gets incremented by one automatically whenever a new record is inserted. As and when you insert any record in the table, this variable gets automatically increment by one. Okay, got it? Now since everything is running in the for loop, abhi mera ek record insert hua. Till now I have inserted only one record. Now I am asking the user again whether you want to insert more record. If user press Y, whether in upper, the while loop will get true and another record will be asked from the user. But if except Y, user type any other key, the while loop will get fail. I just show you this the implementation of it. ये देखो, मैंने कुछ रिकॉर्ड पहले से एंटर किए हुए, ठीक है, वो मैं अभी आपको दिखाऊंगा. Some records already I have inserted. Enter the E code. I am saying 117. Enter E name. I am saying Dheeraj. Enter salary 35,000. Enter department finance. One record get inserted successfully. Do you want to insert another record? No, I don't want to insert any other record. All the records get displayed here, jo maine table mein pehle hi insert kiye. I show you MySQL also, where this new record Dheeraj will be shown. Select star from EMP1. Check it out. ब्रिजेश तक तो मैंने पहले से इंसर्ट किए थे, धीरज का रिकॉर्ड मैंने आज इंसर्ट किया है. चेक आउट द लास्ट रिकॉर्ड, ऑल ऑफ यू चेक आउट द लास्ट रिकॉर्ड धीरज. हैव यू नोटिस्ड 12th क्लास ऑलवेज ओनली वन थंब इज रेज्ड. आई थिंक सो मेनी आर अटेंडिंग द लेक्चर वेयर यू आर लॉस्ट. Everybody must give the feedback because this is for all, not just for Maulik and Sanvinder and Abhishek and Mohit. Now moving back to your coding part. This was about your insertion of records as per the user choice. Okay. Suppose you want to enter single record. You don't want to go with this user's choice and all. आपको एक ही record insert करना है. तो उसका solution भी है. आप direct यहाँ values लिख दो. 112, Anil, 60,000 salary, director. This is also correct. इसी को चला दो. But when you want to enter the single record. Okay, got it. Now another thing is how you can enter multiple records together. How you can enter the multiple records together. Ye command de di maine. Have I given this command? Okay. Main isko abhi comment bana raha hun. I just show you how to enter the multiple records together. V equal to list open first record 112, Anil, 30,000 salary, sales department. ये एक रिकॉर्ड हो गया, कॉमा 113, ध्रुव 45,000 सैलरी, मैनेजर. ये सेकंड रिकॉर्ड हो गया. थर्ड रिकॉर्ड 119, तरुण 50,000 salary, supervisor. Okay. एक और रिकॉर्ड चाहते हैं आप, 120, कोई भी नाम ले लो, राहुल 48,000 salary and he is क्लेरिकल डिपार्टमेंट. यहां पे लिस्ट का ब्रैकेट बंद कर दो. नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू इंसर्ट मल्टीपल रिकॉर्ड्स इन द टेबल. ओके, ऑल दीज फॉर्मेट स्ट्रिंग्स परसेंटेजेस कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंगली दे विल कीप ऑन रिप्लेसिंग विद दिस. बट हेयर वन चेंज विल कम व्हेन यू आर इंसर्टिंग द मल्टीपल रिकॉर्ड्स using this syntax. List ke andar sare tuples ki form mein you are going to insert the multiple records. That time you will not use the execute function, you will use execute many function. Ye dhyan rakhna, when you are inserting the multiple records as per this criteria, you will not use execute function, but you will use execute many function. Am I clear? With both the ways to, three ways to insert the record. Single record insert, recording up to user choice, and this third is the multiple insertion of the record. In the multiple insertion of record, remember to take execute many function. Clear, 12th class? Yes, please. Any doubt, any queries up till here?